Hi, Minister Dion. Amanda Connolly with iPolitics.ca. Thank you for taking our questions today. There are no shortage of concerns about China's treatment of human rights advocates, such as the Hong Kong booksellers and its detention of the Garratts, not to mention the destabilizing effects of its territorial ambitions in the South China Sea. Given these concerns, why is Canada pursuing closer ties with China? How do you plan to use that relationship to improve human rights and security in the region? And did you specifically raise the case of the Garratts during your discussions with the Foreign Minister today?
我要对刚才这个记者涉及到中国的问题要做一个回应。
I want to make a response to the questions asked by this journalist about China.
你的提问充满了对中国的偏见和所谓不知道从什么地方来的傲慢，我是完全不能接受的。
I have to say that your question is full of prejudice and against China and arrogance, where I don't know where that comes from, and this is totally unacceptable.
你了解中国吗？ 你去过中国吗？ 你知道中国从一个一穷二白的面貌把6亿以上的人摆脱了贫困吗？ 你知道中国现在已经成为人均8000美元的一个世界第二大经济体吗？ 如果我们不能够很好地保护人权的话， 中国能取得这么大的发展吗？ 你知道中国已经把保护人权列入到我们的宪法当中吗？ 我要告诉你， 最了解中国的人权的状况不是你， 而是中国人自己。 你没有发言权， 而中国有发言权。 所以请你不要再做这种不负责任的提问。 中国欢迎一切善意的这种建议， 但是我们拒绝任何无端的指责。
I have to ask whether you understand China. Have you been to China? Do you know that China has lifted more than 600 million people out of poverty? And do you know that China is now the second largest economy in the world from a very low foundation? Do you think development is possible for China without protection of human rights? And do you know that China has written protection and promotion of human rights into our constitution? And other people don't know better than the Chinese people about the human rights condition in China. And it's the Chinese people who are in the best situation, in the best position to have say about China's human rights situation. So I would like to suggest to you that please don't ask questions in such an irresponsible manner. And we welcome goodwill suggestions, but we reject groundless or unwarranted accusations.